Good morning, everyone. We welcome you to worship here at Union Baptist Church. Let's stand together as we sing, "Crown Him with Many Crowns and No Other Name."
Father, we thank you for this moment. God, let us be aware of the holiness of this moment. Let us come to you as your people in this place saying, God, we thank you for everything. We thank you for life. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for our families. We thank you for the people around us that we get to gather together and worship the true and living God. God, let this moment be a moment that refocuses us and recalibrates our minds to know that Jesus is above all. There is no other name but the name that is Jesus that can set us free. God, be with us today. It is in your holy name we pray, Lord. Amen. You may be seated. Well, welcome, welcome, welcome to Union Baptist Church. So glad to see all these smiling faces and some masks that I'm sure are hiding smiling faces this morning. But thank y'all so much. Thank you to all of our people who are joining us online this morning. Today's Communion Sunday. I'm excited. If you walked in, you got a little cup. Don't squeeze that thing too hard or there will be some stains on the carpet, please. Remembering is kind of the word that God kept putting in my head today. You know, Jesus says, do this in remembrance of me. So in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 18, I was reading these words. For Christ also suffered once for sins, the righteous for the unrighteous, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit. And here's something I know to be true about God. You guys ready for this? It's a word that you guys can come back to and remember. It's a trustworthy saying, as they say. He doesn't halfway do anything. Our God doesn't halfway do anything. So when it says here that he was put to death, gave his righteousness for the unrighteous, I know that he fully did that. When he died to set us free from sins, I know that he fully did that. So I know that this is not something that I have to add to this morning. I don't have to make sure that I'm good enough this morning. What Jesus has said is, if you have called on my name, you're good enough already, child. Jesus doesn't halfway do anything. He didn't halfway set you free. So if this morning you're still walking in chains, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but it was your own decision. Because Jesus has completely set us free. And I don't say that so that you beat yourself up this morning. I say that because the truth is that there is freedom for each and every one of us in this room today. Freedom that we can come to the Lord Jesus and be set free. For scripture says, for whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And I would hate for anyone to walk out of this place today in unnecessary chains. Because know that that's what they are. They're unnecessary. We are not called to be slaves to anything. We are called to be sons and daughters, free sons and daughters of the Most High King. Please. Today, if a slave is what you are, if chained, a prisoner is what you are, you don't have to leave this place that way. There's freedom in the name of Jesus. Today is a day that can be the story of your life. Will you please continue with us as we worship today?
We sing the great hymns of our faith, which remind us of the great love that was expressed by Jesus for each of us through the cross and his death there, but not the end, the resurrection and the power over death, so that we might know eternity with him as we place our faith and trust in him. At the cross, where I first saw the light.
Thank you.
Wonderful Counselor, Savior, precious Redeemer and Friend. Who would have thought that a Lamb could rescue the souls of men? Oh, to rescue the souls of men. Counselor, Comforter, Healer, Spirit we long to embrace. You offer hope when our hearts have hopelessly lost the way. Oh, we've hopelessly lost the way. Oh.
Almighty, infinite Father, faithfully loving your own, here in our weakness you find us falling before your throne. Oh, we're falling before your throne. You are the one that we pray. Always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger
So good this morning to worship with you, either here or online. I want to make a quick announcement. We had some pastors from our association to visit over in Louisiana after Hurricane Laura had gone through, and of course there was devastation in several areas in Louisiana, but they visited a particular area named Maryville, Louisiana, and Dr. Brad Arnett at Harmony Baptist Church and Ray Spence at Corinth had gone over there. I think Jeff went and Brother Ray went, and several others churches had gone over to kind of do a check to see what they needed. And they've gone over, and if there's anyone that's looking to donate or help in any way to gather some things together, we can gather some things as well. If you want to donate, you can give to the church. We can send one check. But if there's some supplies that need to be gathered, you can also get in contact with us, and we can share those needs with the people over in Maryville. There's a hashtag Maryville4, the number 4. I had that just a second ago. I'm sorry, Hope4Maryville. That's hashtag Hope4Maryville. And you can get in contact with us. We'll have a list printed out of needs that they have at the church office this week, and so you can come by, maybe pick that up. And if you're looking to donate specific items, some of those items are going to be hard to find. You know, with the rainwater and with all the damage that's done, you know, disinfectants and things like that are going to be hard to come by. But there are going to be crews going in with chainsaws and different groups that are going to go in and stay for several days, but then there's going to be some one-day crews go in. So let us know if there's something that you can do to help, and we'll try to get you in contact with some crews that are going in, or if you just want to donate. Another way you can donate is through the Mississippi Baptist Disaster Relief. We have a great group that is with Mississippi Baptist that is part of the Southern Baptist group and Mississippi Baptist, and we support them wholeheartedly. They do a lot of great work. Some trained men, they go through training throughout the year, and they go into these areas, and they do food, and they do chainsaw groups, they do cleanup. There's a great ministry that's done through those groups. So we are supporting them as well. We'll have a link on our website if you want to give through that as well. It has been a great deal of time since we've actually had a Lord's Supper service. It's been several months, and I'll tell you, I've missed it. I've missed having an opportunity to celebrate the Lord's Supper service with you. I know it's going to be a little bit different this morning, but I'm so glad that we can do this. I'll just remind you of a couple of things as we go through this time. One, that these little containers that you have two pieces of plastic. As you take one piece of plastic off, that's going to reveal the wafer on top, and then the second piece is going to reveal the juice. And so be very careful in opening those up, because the plastic is very thin, so don't squeeze it too tight when you're opening. That's why we gave you a napkin. So you spill it, you clean it up. Secondly, if you're wearing a mask, make sure you take the mask off before you start to take. I don't know how many times I've had a mask on and I've had a drink with a straw in it and went to drink and went, oh, I've got to take my mask off. I've got to drink it without the mask on. So just some things to remember. Also, remembering, that's what we're talking about this morning, remembering what Jesus Christ did for us. This is why we partake of the Lord's Supper service. That's why we were commanded to do so. It's so that we don't forget. We forget a lot of things, and it's hard not to forget. There's so much to do, so many things that are going on in our lives, so many things that get us distracted, and we forget a lot. And the older we get, the more we forget, right? But there's more that we forget that we probably should remember, but the one thing we should never forget is what Jesus Christ did for us. That's the greatest message that we've ever received in all of our life, and it's the message we should always remember, and that's why we remind ourselves so often of what Jesus did. And so remembering me is a statement that is, remember me is a statement that Jesus made when he said, when you do this, remember me. Yeah, when you think about this, and in times when you do this, remember me. Well, these things, what did he do? What does this remind us of? First of all, it reminds us that he was a suffering servant. The idea of thinking of the wafer and of the juice is to symbolize what Christ did for us. These represent pieces of something that Jesus did. It represents the body and the blood of Jesus. It was very confusing for those first century people when they heard that Christians were eating the body and drinking the blood of Jesus. That sounded so weird. It had an idea that maybe they were cannibals, but that's not really what it was about. They weren't actually literally eating the body and blood of Christ. It was a symbol because it was incorporated into the Passover meal that they were sharing with one another concerning the Passover meal, of how Jesus liberated them out of bondage into freedom, and how each of those elements of the unleavened bread and of the bitter herb and of the of all the nutty conglomerate of things that they ate were all part of the symbols of how they left Egypt so quickly and how God delivered them. All of that had symbols when it came. I wish we could have done the Passover Haggadah, the Passover Seder service. That's actually what we were planning on doing the last time we were going to have the Lord's Supper service. It actually lined up with the Passover. We were going to actually have that. I don't know if you remember that. I took a survey of how many people were going to participate, and we had Dr. Dennis Cole that was going to come and actually have that for us, and we were going to do the Passover service. That didn't happen. So, well, fortunately, we didn't get to see all of those elements as part of this experience, and so we do miss out a little bit to know that this was a symbol. This was just something that Jesus said, this is the new covenant that I'm setting before you. He didn't come to abolish the law. He came to fulfill the law. He came to show us that this is a completion of what God had already set into motion. But these symbols were what Jesus was going to endure for us as the suffering servant. That his body was going to endure so much pain for us. We were supposed to receive that punishment. We deserve that because of our sin, and yet Christ stood in our place and received the punishment on himself. When we think about this wafer, we should think about what Jesus did as he stood in our place. And the juice represents the blood of Christ, because the Bible says that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. It goes all the way back to Adam and Eve, when God killed an animal so that he could cover over their sin, their nakedness. After they disobeyed him, because of their sin, an animal died. Because of our sin, Jesus died for us. He suffered for us. He became the one and only sacrifice that would ever satisfy a holy God. He suffered for us. So we shouldn't forget what Jesus did. You're also supposed to remember that even though he suffered for us and he endured that pain, he is our Savior. He did that for us so that we would not have to spend an eternity in hell. We were in need. We needed someone to take our place. We couldn't make it on our own. So Jesus took our place and he saved us. He didn't, like Corey said, he didn't do anything halfway. He completed it. It is finished. There's nothing left undone. Jesus is our Savior. I'm so thankful that my security is in the one and only one that could have purchased it. My salvation is in the one who was perfect. I trust you guys, but if you would have died for me to save me from going to hell, I don't know. Y'all aren't perfect. I'd probably say the same thing about me. Jesus was perfect. He's the only one that could have done it. Jesus is our Savior. We should never forget that he's the one we owe our life to. He's the one that we owe it all to. We were bought with a price. When we talk about this Lord's Supper service, it's a reminder for us that we are not our own anymore. The life that we lived, what we're enjoying now, what we're going to enjoy one day in heaven, is because of Jesus, not because of us. Don't start getting on a high horse because you think you've done something. Don't think you're somebody because all of a sudden you think you've got it all together because of something you did. It's because of what Jesus did. We're only here because of Jesus. He's the one we glorify. He's the one we magnify. He's the one that we exalt. He's the only one that gets praise. He's the only one that we can call Savior. And that's why we remember that, that it's not about us, it's about him. This life that we're living is because of Jesus and no one else. He suffered and he is our Savior, but you know what? I love the fact that we have a new life in Christ. He took our place. We need to acknowledge that every day. We were bought with a price. We have new life right now. But one day, Jesus is coming back. Oh, what a day that's going to be. I know that this is what's going to happen. One day, Jesus is going to come back, and woo, we're going to be gone. But I would love to see some looks on some people's faces. Wouldn't you? I'm not normally a person that would say, "I told you so." That's one of those times I really wish I could say, "I told you so." Been trying to say I told you so for quite a while now. You better get ready, because Jesus is coming back. The things that we need to be doing now, you better get ready, because he's coming back. There's a lot of people concerned, but they're concerned about the wrong things nowadays. Everybody's looking to see what the next bad thing is coming down the road, right? 2020 has been, we've been filled with a lot of bad stuff this year, right? I wonder what bad's going to happen next. I'm kind of going, I wonder what good's coming around the corner. Jesus may be coming. We're reminded two things. One, there's better days ahead. There's better days ahead, amen? There's some good time, there's some good things going to happen. We're gonna get to see Jesus face to face. Oh, that's enough right there in and of itself. We're going to be reunited with, and that's not my second thing, but we're going to be reunited with loved ones. Amen. There's some people that I want to see. We're going to have no more pain, no more suffering, no more tears. All of that's waiting for us. But the second thing that reminds us is that we better get busy. There's things that need to be done right here and now. There's an urgency that needs to happen if Jesus is coming back. We need to be ready. We need to be prepared. There's a list of things to do. And God's placed them all in his word. And we better be about his work even now. There's a lot of concerns that we've got in this life right now. But if we're not concerned with the things of God, even in the midst of all that's going on, we've misplaced our priorities. So we've got to stay about the work of God, because Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back. It's a reminder. It's a reminder for us that there's a world that needs Jesus, and we've got the answer. It's a reminder that we are to be the light and the salt to a world that desperately needs the answer to all its problems, and that's Jesus. He's our answer. I've seen people mock his name. I've seen people laugh at his name. I've seen people ridicule his name. I've seen people laugh at his followers, saying Jesus isn't the answer. And they toss away truly the only way that they could ever have peace and everlasting life. I'm praying their hearts would be opened and their lives would be changed, that they will truly see that what they're getting rid of, what they're trying to dismiss, because he is the way, the truth, and the life. And nobody comes into the Father except through him. He's the only way that we're going to get to heaven. He's the only way that we can have wholeness. He's the only way that we can have forgiveness of sin. He's the only way that we can have contentment. Do you know him today? Do you remember what he did for you? If you do know him, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can come to you and remember. Remember what you did so long ago that still impacts our hearts and lives today. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would move in this invitation time, that if there's someone that needs to know you and as their Lord and Savior this morning, that they would ask you into their heart. Just simply by saying, Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. I know that you died on the cross for my sins. I ask you to come into my heart this morning to be my Lord and Savior. I repent from my sins and I turn to you to be the Lord of my life, to be my Savior. Thank you for saving my soul and changing my life. I pray, God, that if there's someone here that's done that, that they'll make that public. If there's someone that's watching at home, that they'll let somebody know that Jesus is real in their life today. And Lord, if there's Christians here that just need to remember, that just need to recommit, pray, God, that in our hearts we would say, Lord, I know that there's things that I have in my life I need to confess. There's things that I need to get right with you. I pray right now that you would cleanse me, that you would move in me and show me those things that I need to repent of. Thank you for reminding me of all the great things that you have done for me and reminding me of who you are, challenging me, Holy Spirit, to live for you each and every day. So, Heavenly Father, move in my life in a new and wonderful way. I pray, God, that you would just move in this invitation time so that, Heavenly Father, your name will be glorified. And your kingdom will be built according to your power, according to your name. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Let's just stand together as we sing Grace Greater Than Our Sin.
Marvelous grace of our loving Lord, grace that exceeds our sin and our
Kaylee comes this morning, and we talked Wednesday night after GA's, and she said that she wanted to be baptized, and we talked about that and said, well, what does it mean to be baptized? And She knew exactly what it meant to be baptized, and she said she wanted to ask Jesus Christ to come into her heart to be her Lord and Savior. So Wednesday night she prayed and asked Jesus to come into her heart and said she wanted to let everybody know this morning. And so if you would welcome her and to be baptized next Sunday, if you want to rejoice with her in this, signify by saying amen. All right, we'll let you guys have a seat right quick, and we're going to have our Lord's Supper service, and she'll get to participate with us in that. After the service, she's going to go out and ring the bell, so make sure you stay around a little bit for that. And at this time, you may have a seat. I'll be reading from the passage of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 26. Paul is writing to the church at Corinth, and he says, "For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, in the night which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it." If you would, go ahead and tear back that piece of cellophane, the top piece. If you will, let's have a word of prayer together. Heavenly Father, we do thank you that this wafer represents the body of Jesus Christ that was broken for us. We thank you for what it represents. We thank you for the sacrifice that you made, Jesus, that by your stripes that we were healed. We thank you that even though you endured the pain and you endured the suffering of not only the humiliation and the pain of the cat of nine tails, we know the pain of the crown of thorns upon your head. We know that you endured the cross for us because you loved us. We pray, God, that we will never forget. We will remember what you did for us in that you loved us and you cared for us. And we know that you are our Lord and Savior. We thank you, Jesus, for the sacrifice that you made for our lives. May we never forget so that we live for you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. He said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper. If you'll tear that back. Let's bow in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you as we celebrate this symbol of your blood that was shed for us. We know that the sacrifice was at a price. We know that you went to great lengths to bring about salvation for us. This was no easy task, and you did not just tell us that you loved us. You demonstrated your love toward us and that while we were yet sinners, you died for us. So we pray that we would not take this lightly in the sacrifice that you made. We thank you for shedding your blood for us, that we might have eternal life. May we always remember that the price that you paid was a heavy price. And you've called us to a great mission and a great life because you're a great God. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. He took the cup after and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as oft as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as oft as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And praise the Lord that he is coming one day. Now we're going to ask you, if you will, take these empty cups, and we have a receptacle in the lobby. If you will take them with you, and we'll dispose of them with your napkin in that receptacle in the lobby. That way we don't have to go through and pick them up from the pews. We appreciate that. Just a couple of quick announcements as we close. We will be beginning the adult Sunday school program next Sunday morning. Again, we're not starting our nursery quite yet. We're hoping to start that soon, but we are starting our adult Sunday school class next Sunday morning, beginning at 8:45. That is September 6th, and we're looking forward to those classes meeting. Again, we're trying to do everything we can to accommodate. Please, if you have any questions, please let us know, and we look forward to seeing God's Word again taught in those Sunday school classes. Also, we are continuing to give with our offerings in the foyer. There will be plates in the foyer. You can give online and at ubcnet.org, mail in, or at the church office. We have a Pearl River Baptist Association men's meeting that will be Tuesday night at 6:30 at West Union Baptist Church. Youth nights of worship have been moved to Tuesday nights at 6:30. We have an in-person prayer time on Wednesday at 1 p.m., so if you want to come to prayer time, it is 1 p.m. on Wednesdays. And then we also still do the Facebook Live on Wednesday nights at 6:30. Again, if you want to find out more information about the relief efforts for Hurricane Laura in Maryville, please let us know at the church office this week, and we would love to give you more information about that.